We've got Angel El Toro Hernandez, who tonight will not necessarily be fighting at that weight, but maybe sort of a El Calf Hernandez, because you're fighting for the middleweight title.
Yes, for the IBO International.
And Angel, you have fought at heavier weights before than this, haven't you?
No, this is the heaviest weight I always fight, you know, because natural I'm 147 or 154, but this time I'm gonna make my last fight in 160.
Now, you had mentioned in the past that you had gone in and out of training. When you weren't with Chicago Fight Club, you were kind of like on your own, and your weight drifted up and down and kind of interfered with your boxing career?
No. You know, being in Chicago Boxing Club is helping me a lot in my career, because I meet, you know, I got a lot of good guys right there, like Fearless Hernandez. He's the main trainer, and I'm really focused right there. I feel really comfortable right there.
Now, do you know anything about your opponent tonight?
He's really aggressive. He's tall. That's all I know of him.
Now you're at 160 now.
Yeah, I'm 160. I'm right now 166. Yeah, but I feel really good right now.
And what is the most that you want to weigh? Is the middleweight division the one you want to stay in? Or would you like to get down to welterweight? Because did you fight Peter Manfredo?
Yeah, I fought Peter Manfredo in New York like 6 months ago.
Yeah, and you at that time you were like 147, weren't you?
No, I fought him 160. He's a heavy fighter too. Like, he's a natural one middleweight, and I'm not a natural middleweight. I have to be welterweight, but you know, because of my problem with the weight, I have to fight 160 this time. But what I say, this is going to be the last time that I fight 160.
And when you say this will be the last time you fight at 160, what will you be doing now, going down to 155 or 54 or something?
Going down 154 and stay there.
And you've been down there, haven't you?
Yeah, my good fights, that was in 154.
Are you ready to go? What are we going today, 10, 12?
I'm going to try to finish fast as I can.
You made a good impression during that Peter Manfredo fight. Angel, we'll be watching El Toro in that four-cornered corrida. Okay? All right. To my left, right, who will be fighting Angel El Toro Hernandez is an El Toro in his own way of thinking and his own way of fighting, because he was like a bull during the last time I saw him fight here against Donovan George. And you had just come from Ghana, and he took Donovan, 10 rounds, and he gave Donovan George everything he could handle, and a lot of people felt more than he could handle. So what brought you back to the United States? Or had you been fighting here a long time? The first time I'd ever seen you.
Yeah, the first time since then, nobody want to fight me because I fought Donovan George. And most of my fight, they're calling for super middleweight, and I'm not super middleweight, I'm middleweight. Move to middleweight. I'm not super middleweight.
When you fought Donovan George, it was a super middleweight fight?
It was super middleweight. It was super middleweight. And I don't fight super middleweight. I took that fight, you know. I feel like I can do it. And people know I can do it.
Now, your trainer is Joseph?
Joseph Arreno, yeah.
And it's like, is that a Greek name or something like that? I had a hard time pronouncing it, whatever it might be. But Joseph?
It's a way African name. It's an African name.
And you're from Ghana also?
Ghana, yeah, I'm from Ghana. I'm an ex-professional boxer, retired professional boxer. So got a chance to bring the African people, you know, right here in Chicago here. And also my training is a little bit different. I bring most of the African guys who come to this country to fight. Sometimes they forget how hard they work when they come to this country, and then they start slowing down again. So now to find somebody who knows the same route that they come from, to train them hard that way. So that's why I make everything good.
So you're saying that they forget the hard times, just as they forget the hard times in the ring, just as the hard times in the country.
In the country, they forget the hard time, they start living like everything. Everything is okay. Uh-huh. Yeah, so now since I'm doing this in Chicago here, I found a way to bring the old stuff out, so it make them feel good. They look good, they look sharp, they look everything. This fight, then the guy gonna have a lot of things coming up to him.
Well, you have actually trained at Chicago Fight Club, haven't you? So you know a little bit about Angel El Toro Hernandez.
Yeah, we saw him on this team. We know about him.
Okay, we'll find out more about the bull from Ghana against the bull from Mexico. El Toro Adama against El Toro Hernandez.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the UIC Pavilion in Chicago, Illinois, this is our main event of the evening. Introducing to you first to my left, quiet tonight out of the blue corner. He's wearing green trunks with yellow trim and weighed in at 159.5 pounds. Fighting out of Joliet, Illinois, by way of Akko, Ghana, Africa. His professional record consists of 17 wins, 2 defeats, with 13 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the former African champion, Osumanu Adama.
Fighting for this IBO middleweight championship from Ghana. Osumanu Adama, who's out of the blue corner.
He's wearing black trunks trimmed in silver.
The African champion, Osumanu Adama.
60 pounds. Fighting out of Chicago, Illinois, by way of San Luis Potosi, Mexico. His professional record consists of 30 wins, 8 defeats, with 17 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the former welterweight champion, Angel El Toro Hernandez.
Angel Hernandez fighting out of the red corner. Hernandez fighting for Chicago Fight Club.
Gentlemen, receive your instructions. Just a moment, expect the team to touch your fight. And my command,
Dobbin green with the white trim. Hernandez in black with the silver trim. Some weight in this fight. By that, he's a natural 147-pounder. He's fighting at 160 for this bout. Daba's tailor-made for this weight division. Him off balance as he tried to get away. That made him vulnerable, but he seems to have recovered. Hernandez giving up height as well as weight. He's clearly fighting out of his division. But he's aggressive. He's not taking any prisoners himself. Defending. by his waist. It's a hunter's stance. Jabs as Hernandez tries to close. Hernandez wants to get into a street fight. Hernandez has his defensive hands down below his chin. He can take a hit or two. Gabaz has scored with a punch now and then, but he hasn't taken complete advantage of that vulnerability. Dab is looking for a scenario, and he's trying to develop one. Hernandez can be hit, but you got to be careful that he doesn't hit back. If you're going to hit him, you better escape. Right hand jolt at Hernandez's face. There's another left hand, and Angel seems to be trying to hang on. Not for long, though. Another right hand by Adaba. Another one. Angel looks like he doesn't know where he is exactly. He's taking a lot of punches. He's hanging on for dear life, but he's getting hurt here. And like the warrior that he is, he fights back. Punches are a little bit wide. He's got his face exposed, but I think he's willing to take that chance. There's a left hand by Odaba. Angel keeps trying to come. Moving his head slowly left and right. Odaba has Angel in trouble here. He's plucking his head like a plum off a tree. Another combination by Odaba. Weathers the storm. Odaba tries to pick up where the round ended. Whether Hernandez will be recovered by the rest will soon be evident or not. He looks strong as he throws a right hand into Odaba. Good job of slipping those punches off of Odaba. Body punches by Odaba. Reaching for some of those punches. Thank you. encouraged by a near hit and close that round out in the wrestling match. Round five. And right combination by Ogawa, and again, and he drives Hernandez back, and Hernandez is visibly hurt for the first time in this fight. He's still slipping and moving, and he avoided the brunt of Odawa's attack after that slow scoring punches by the Ganon. Odawa is out quicking Hernandez, but Hernandez is still hanging in there. There doesn't seem to be an ounce of quit in him. Round six. Fights back. This is a Hernandez who's most comfortable at 147 pounds, and he's fighting 160 today. matches there. He controls this fight, but he has not beaten Angel Hernandez. Angel tries to come back, and the two wrestle in the corner. Is with his hands higher now off of his head, in front of his face now. Odaba is a good counterpuncher. When Hernandez goes to the body, Odaba quickly scores to the head. Hernandez is not really stunned by punches, but the points pile up. Odaba sees that right hand dropped down by Angel's waist, and he takes advantage of it. The advantage is obvious sometimes. See here, that left out Hernandez now. It's up and now comes down. Short on his right hand punches, but they do come over his shoulder with power. He's in the right position to throw that right hand. When he throws his right hand, he gets his leg and his glute and his shoulder into those punches. Is putting more punches together, but Hernandez is still pursuing, still pressuring. Odaba's breathing a little bit heavier now. Maybe this is what Hernandez is hoping for. Hernandez does not look like he's breathing heavily. But Odaba is a very elusive figure himself. Nice right hand by Odaba. Angel tries to come back. Odaba turns him around. Nice left hand on the right to the body by Odaba. Another left hand and a second left hand. Right through Hernandez's defenses. Angel off balance as he tried to throw a right hand. Another left hand by Odabo. Another left. Hernandez trying to reach for the diamond. He slips away. Hernandez still tries to step forward, but he's driven back by Odabo. But he comes back again. You might call this fight a civil war of sorts. Almost all the fighters on one side tonight, Angel Hernandez is one of them, is grateful to Wasfi Tolomat of Chicago Fight Club. Tolomat took these guys away from their wandering ways and put them on a steady payroll at Chicago Fight Club and enables them not to have to worry about going from fight to fight. Tolomat is new to the boxing world, but he's determined to make a mark. And he puts his money where his mouth is. He supports about half of the boxers on the card tonight. Each one of them works at Chicago Fight Club. Side and hold. The combinations on both sides can be very crisp. Thank you. 10. Peter Manfredo in a title type bout and gave away another 15 pounds and impressed the HBO people there, as he is tonight here. Two, three punch combination. Thank you. This is it. Go for broke. Fields, he's behind hopelessly on points. He's certainly fighting like he is not going to accept that.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of boxing, we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge Patrick Morley scores it 119 to 109. And both judges, Bulmaro Campuzano Jr. and John Epperson, are in agreement, scoring at the same 120 to 108. All in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And now the IBO International Middleweight Champion,
To very few people surprised, Osumano Madaba is your IBO middleweight champion. Angel Hernandez, as usual, giving away weight, but giving his best and never quitting for a second. You'll see more of him as a
lot. On behalf of 8 Count Productions,
we Chicago Fight Club, that's boxing at UIC
Pavilion. And tonight's event, also on behalf of CFC Promotions, we thank you for coming out and supporting tonight's event. We look forward to seeing you again next year. Happy holidays. Remember, great boxing action returns here to the UIC Pavilion on January 28th. Get your tickets in advance and make a great stocking stuffer. My name is Thomas Driver. Good night, please, Thomas.
Good night, everyone.